Hi everyone. In the last class, we have seen the concept of CSS transforms, which are meant for to perform some changes for an element. Okay, fine. In today's class, we will see the concept of CSS transitions. These transitions are meant for to change the properties of an element, to change the properties of an element over a given duration. For example, in the last class, we have seen some kind of changes, like I am going to make rotate, or I'm going to make some kind of scaling, or I'm going to make some kind of transformation. All these we have seen in the previous class. Yeah, fine. Here the properties means these properties also can be included. Like for example, I can able to rotate, or I can able to change the background color, or I can able to change the height of the element, or I can able to change the width of the element, or anything. It can be like any kind of transform property, etc. If you would like to change any properties of an element over a given duration of time, then we'll go for CSS transitions. Right? Yeah, fine. So generally, we are going to apply any kind of property actually. But the thing is, you require at least two properties to visualize all these things. What are those means? You have to set, or you have to define which property you want to change first thing. That is the first thing you require. And another thing is, you need to define that duration of the effect. Without defining these two things, we can't able to visualize the things. Like for example, I would like to change the width of the element. And I have defined the duration as 0 seconds. Then you can't visualize it, whether it is changing or not, but drastically we are going to observe that the width is increased. If you would like to visualize the movement also, the changing also, then we need to give the duration as at least 1 second. I mean, at least 1 second means instead of giving 0 seconds, you can give any value. What I'm saying is, don't get confused. If you would like to apply the concept of CSS transitions, you have to define these transitions for a property. And this property to visualize clearly how much duration you want to apply this property. If you are saying that it is 0 seconds, directly it will change from one position to another position, but you can't visualize it, right? So to visualize it, I need to define some 5 seconds or some 1 second or that, like that. For example, in the last class, we have seen this concept. Whenever I place cursor over here, actually it is rotating. But we are not visualizing. Because here the duration is 0 seconds. So to make some duration to this one, you can observe whether it is rotating or not. Similarly, you can observe this skin. Whenever I place cursor over here, here also I am performing some kind of rotation actually. But it is directly moving from this part location to this part location. So to make it visualize clearly, I need to set some kind of duration along with the concept of transitions. Yeah, here also you can observe that same thing. So for that, what you can do is, we are going to see a property called transition property. Which is a shorthand property. I hope you know the meaning of shorthand property, which is going to combine all the properties of transitions into a single property called shorthand property. Yeah. Before going to visualize this shorthand property, let me go for all kind of various properties. One is transition property. The property name is transition property. Mean that for which property you want to apply these transitions? Meaning that for which transitions you want to apply this effect, that property unit effect. Like for example, I would like to apply some transitions for rotation or background effect are some kind of height, weight, transforming, all those. Yeah. And the minimum requirement is this one, as well as one more property called transition duration. If I'm going to define the transition duration as 0 seconds, there is no difference between that transform property as well as this transition property. So this is like a transform along with 0 seconds. So you need to give some more than 0 seconds, some more than 0 seconds, meaning that the duration of the effect, meaning that once the effect is started, how much duration that effect should be waited. Okay, next kind of property called transition timing function. Transition timing function. So this transition timing function is meant for to define speed curve of the effect. To define speed curve of the transition effect. Transition effect. Yeah. Fine. So what is speed curve of the transition effect? All those I will explain. Don't worry. So here we'll have various kind of properties. Let me go for all those. First kind of value is is, which is meant for. So okay, fine. So what I will do is I will go for this thing later part of the class, so that you can understand clearly. Yeah. Then before going to that, I'll go for one more property called transition delay. Transition delay, which is meant for delaying the transition, meaning that before going to start the transmission, before going to make effects, how much time that the transition has to wait? That thing we are going to define with the help of delay. Meaning that if I define like 5 seconds, after 5 seconds, these effects are going to make happen. Yeah. So in order to combine all these things, in order to write all these lines in a 4 lines of code, instead of that, you can go for a shortened property called transition, and you can write all this in a separate by a space. So you know the meaning of shortened property, right? That thing, so that you can understand this thing. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the same example which I have taken the first class. Basic.html, I have taken this one. Here, what I'm going to do is instead of making everything anyway, there is no problem. What I will do is I would like to go for some kind of transition property. For example, what transition property I would like to change? For example, I would like to change my transition property as width, whenever I am placing cursor over here, I would like to increase the size of the width. Width size increase, that you need to observe actually. Fine. So I will make it comment, and I will go for one more time. Transform width. Sorry. Scale. So if you would like to scale y axis, right? Then I need to go for scale y too. I'm going to refresh. Whenever I place cursor, yeah, on y axis I am moving. I'm sorry. On x axis I would like to move. Yeah. Place cursor, yes. We increasing the width or not? But this width is suddenly increasing as you observe. Yeah. I don't want like that. I would like to make it visualize clearly. Then I will go for transition property. So which property would like to change? I would like to change the width property. Yeah, fine. And so whenever I place cursor on this one, I would like to change my width. So how much width you would like to change? For example, I would like to change from 100 pixel to 300 pixel. Actually, the transfer property is width. So observe here, I have refreshed. Whenever I place cursor, is it increasing or not? Yeah. So that is what I said. Transition property means we are going to change the properties over a given duration of time. But here, how much duration it is taking? 0 seconds. 0 second. If you would like to visualize it clearly, then I'll go for transition duration. Transition duration. For example, I'm going for defining 5 seconds. Observe, guys, whenever I place cursor, it is changing slowly from one position to another position. Fine. For example, I would like to increase the height. Increase the height. Height equal to height also, height some 500 pixel, let me or height some 300 pixel so that you will get clarity. Fine. Observe. Both will change at the same time. In 5 seconds, one is 300 pixel, another one is 300 pixels. Yeah. For example, I would like to apply those effects to some kind of time change. For example, I would like to go for apply the property to height also. But this height, I would like to define. For example, let me take this is 3 seconds and this is 5 seconds. What is the meaning of this one? Width effect is going to affect in 3 seconds of time, meaning that from 100 pixel to 300 pixel, it is going to affect in 3 seconds of time. Height is affecting in 5 seconds of time. It's affecting 5 seconds of time. Observe. Changing, changing. Now how it is increasing after some amount of time where the width is constant. Yeah. If you want to visualize one more time, 7 seconds I am taking. Observe. Width decrease, width stopped, but height is increasing because I have given the duration as 7 seconds. So at the same time, I would like to change the background color. Change the background color as red color. Am I getting it or not? Yeah. Fine. For example, I would like to change something like, let me go for, instead of all this, I would like to define some transform property. For example, transform property. So the transform property is going to define, I would like to translate both x-axis as well as y-axis. Let me take both x-axis as well as y-axis. And I need to rotate. I need to rotate over 180 degrees. Or let me go for first this one. Have you observed anything here? You can observe. Is there anything is doing? No. Is there any effect you are observing? No. Because would it define any kind of transform property? That is a minimum requirement. So on which transform property you need to define, that thing you have to define. So for example, I'm going to define the transform property as transform. How many seconds you would like to see that effect? For example, 5 seconds. Now observe. During 5 seconds of time, it is moving from one position to another position. That is the meaning of translate property. Yeah, fine. Now, I need to move both x-axis as well as y-axis while rotating. I would like to have 180 degrees. Okay. It will rotate 180 degrees also. Moving 180 degrees. Yeah, because 180 degrees means just opposite, right? Opposite plane. You can observe, visualize this. In 3 degrees. Finally, the result will be in the 3 degrees location. Fine. I hope now you understood this one clearly. Yeah. So what I will do is I will come to the actual point. I'll come to the actual point. I would like to go for only width. I would like to define the property for only width. Property for only width, and this is 5 seconds. Other guys, yes. How it is moving, like enlarging. You can observe some kind of speed curve, right? For example, I am going for some kind of 800 pixel. Observe, whenever I place cursor, how it is moving. Initially, it starts slowly. In the middle, it is going to fast, and at the end, it is going to end slowly. One second, observe. Fast and now slow. Observe once again. Slow, start fast, and end slowly. This property we call it as a transition timing function. Transition timing function. So what this transition timing function is going to do is while implementing the effect, the speed is there, right? Speed of the element is there. That speed curve, it is going to define. It is going to define whether it is an ease or whether it is an linear or whether it is an ease in or whether it is an ease out or whether it is an ease in out or it's a kind of some other property which I will explain later. These are the various kind of values it is going to accept. The meaning of the ease is it is going to start slowly and in the middle it is going to make it fast and at the end it is going to move slowly. Okay, fine. So this is by default term. So if you didn't define any kind of transition timing function, it is going to do like this: observe slowly, fast, and now slowly. Linear means during the entire duration it is going to maintain same speed. What about the ease in? It is going to start slowly and the remaining thing is all fast. Ease out means it is going to end slowly. And easing out means it is a combination of these two: start slowly and end slowly, which will finally yields. It is a combination of slow start and slow end. Yeah. If you observe, guys, I will make it some kind of that thing here. Yeah, transition timing function. As for example, I will make it as a linear. Linear. Observe. If I refresh, observe. Constantly, linearly changing its status. You can work out with all these effects. I will go with ease in out. Yes, right. End slowly. Start slowly and end slowly. Slowly, fast, slow. Yeah, fine. Yeah, here you can observe one thing. If I go for the source code F12 container, yeah, fine. So I would like to go for here. Yes, I see here you can observe. Yes, guys, here you can observe the thing. So this defines the transition timing function. Observe what I have defined here: ease in, ease out, ease in, out. Yeah, fine. So for example, here you can observe what happening here. Speed is increasing. Observe, I'm going to copy this one. I'm going to paste here. And I'm going to refresh once again. Place the thing. What happened? Speed is, so according to that one, that property, it is moving. Or else, so to make it clear visualization, I will go for like this. What happened? Start slowly and end fastly. I'll copy this. I will just close. Observe. I place the cursor, start slowly and go fast. Moving fast, decreasing slowly and come to very fast. Yeah, so that is the another kind of function amma here. What is that means? Cubic Bezier function. So if you want, you can have a website also amma, that I have already seen that, cubicbezier.com. yeah. So here also you can set the curve, speed curve of an element, and you can copy this function. Save to library. You can copy this function and those values, and you can paste it. Observe. For example, I'm going to save this library, and I'm going to copy these values. I'm going to paste it here. Those properties will be applied. What happened? It is having some effect. What is that effect? Slowly increasing, decreasing, again increasing. Yeah. that is the advantage of this cubic cubic biser, which is in the property called transition timing function here. And one more thing I would like to show here, transition delay. Transition delay. For example, I would like to make a delay of 3 seconds. What is the meaning of this one? Or else I will go for this as some linear, so that you can understand. So I am going to place cursor. After 3 seconds, it is going to start effect. Observe. It is going to effect. So that is the meaning of transition delay. Okay. Now what I will do is, so let me go for a shorthand property. I'm going to comment all this. I'm going to apply a shorthand property, the transition shorthand property. So on which I would like to define, for example, I would like to define the property called width. How many seconds the duration? 5 seconds. And for example, I would like to have a linear timing function, and the like duration of the effect is delaying is 1 second. After 1 second, it is going to start effect. Yeah. For example, I would like to have more. Then I will go for height. One more. So meaning that you can combine all this. Height, duration is some 7 seconds. Transition time function is starting is 2 seconds delay. One second, after 2 seconds, height is increasing. Yeah. So this is the concept of transition property. Transition property. Okay, fine. So if you apply the same concept for the other pages also, like media, transition medium, what you can do is, for example, let me go for here. So you can observe. So this is the middle, right? Whenever I place cursor, you are not visualizing anything. But if you would like to visualize, I could go for a transition function. So transition, I'm going to take the shorthand property. So which property I would like to apply? Transform. Transform. I already defined for that. So how many seconds the duration? 3 seconds. 3 seconds. So during these 3 seconds, it's going to rotate as well as it is going to increase its size. Rotating and increasing its size. For example, I would like to change the border color to red color. Is there an effect that happened here? No. You can observe. It's not applied here. Yeah, there is no border, then I am applying border color. Yes, now we can observe, right? You can do these things in many ways. So for this, you can define the transition timing function also. Like for example, I'm going to define ease in out. Slow, fast, and slow. Okay, fine. For example, I would like to go for the same thing over this thing, advanced. Yeah, fine, right? So what is happening here? Quickly it is changing, right? I want to see this effect. I will go for this advanced.html. I don't want to change this one. What I will do is, so on this sample itself, I'm going to define a transition. I would like to define the transform property once again. So how many seconds you would like to change? 3 seconds. So meaning that, so once I place cursor over here, it is going to call this transform property and it's going to move over x-axis 500 pixels and it's going to rotate 360 degrees. Observe. Rotating and it is moving its position. Backing. Yeah. Moving its position. Observe. Yeah. So if you would like to increase the scaling, scale on x-axis 2 times. Increasing also. Yes. Fine. Or else you would like to apply some kind of properties. You can add any kind of property, some no problem. For example, I'm adding only effect. You can add the background color, you can add the things, whatever the things you require. Slowly, fast, and comes. Okay. Yes. So this is the concept of transition sum. Yeah. So I hope you understood clearly. Thank you.